Welcome to Doctor Who DVD Season 22. So as you can tell, I've actually put some of my figures out here. The Dalek for Resurrection of the Daleks. Sorry, Revelation of the Daleks. Colin Baker, Patrick Troughton for the two Doctors. Perry on the side with two very grumpy Santarans on the side. Put that there. You can't really see them all on camera, oops. So, the very first DVD we have for Season 22. Now, this came out way back in 2009. And now, I got this from Llandudno when I went on a day trip there. And it is Attack of the Cybermen. This is my second favourite 1980s Cyberman story. For Colin Baker is brilliant as the Doctor, especially when you have him with using the cyber gun. This one I absolutely love. This one is phenomenal. I absolutely loved Attack of the Cybermen. It's the best Cyberman story ever. It featured Return of the Cyber Controller. The Kryons are very first introduced in this story because the planet Terra used to be the home planet. And you even find out what happens to the Cybermen in the sewers at the end of the invasion, because they even appear in this story, but with the new, the 1980s kind of look. So yeah, Attack of the Cybermen is an absolutely fantastic story. So thanks to my mate Zach, he managed to give me the next one. This was released way back in 2001, Vengeance on Varos. Now, I absolutely love Vengeance on Varos. It even has these one of the stars of Benidorm, who plays Madge, and also Clara's Gran in Modern Who, also made her very first Doctor Who debut in this story. It's just an absolutely fantastic one. So, the next one, now, I actually got this one when I was out with my mate Dylan in Shrewsbury. Now, this came out in 2012. I actually picked this up from HMV for £10. And it is the Vengeance of Varos Special Edition. I absolutely love Vengeance of Varos. I even love the artwork to this. Compare it to the original. There's no comparisons. I absolutely do love this story. So, the next one. Now, this one I got given to by my dad. And it is the A Mark of the Irani. Now, this one introduces the Irani for the very first time. We have the Masters makes his return after being burnt to life in Season 21. It's just such an iconic villain, the Master is, especially when you make him team up with the Irani for this story. And you know, the Doctor's got to deal with not one, but two Time Lords. And it's a very, very good Time Lord story. Now, this was actually filmed up in Ironbridge in Telford near me. So I'm actually really, really glad that I got this story. I'm hoping to go up to the film site where they filmed this story, because it's such an iconic episode for Doctor Who. So the next one. Now, this one was partly filmed in the studio and the rest of it was actually filmed in Spain. Now, this DVD was actually released way back in 2003. I actually got it in the Santarin Bread for War box set of my cousin Josh. And it is the two Doctors. As you can see my little display here with the two Doctors. Wow, I absolutely love this story. It's a good Santarin story for the 1980s. Even though the Santarans don't really do much. We have the Androgoms who tries to kill Jamie and eat him. Because he wants to taste human flesh. And it's absolutely a fantastic story. Especially when you have the Doctor becoming a villain himself. The Androgom villain of the Doctor. I just absolutely love the story, and this is Patrick Troughton's last ever appearance as the second Doctor in the story, and it means so much to me, even though it makes Colin Baker's Doctor look a lot better. Even though I can't really say that because I absolutely love Colin's Doctor, but the two Doctors together, especially when you got them bickering, is an absolutely iconic one. So the next one, now this one I was given to by my dad, but I used to have this on VHS before, and it is Time Lash. Now, I absolutely love Time Lash. Not many people like this one, but I actually saw like it because this was my very first ever Colin Baker story I ever watched. And I really, really enjoyed it. I absolutely just love this story so much. Not many people like it, but I actually like the monster design of the Borat. So, the next one, which is the last story of season 22, because halfway through this season, I think it was round about the boring the broadcast of Mark and Rennie, it was announced Doctor Who was going to be put on an 18-month suspension. Wow, 18-month hiatus. And It really did hurt the show. It really did. It had loads of scripts for the original season 23 were scrapped, even though it had one of the stories set in Blackpool and it had to be edited out in Revelation of Daleks. I absolutely love this Dalek story. Davros is amazing in this, creating people, turning people into like glass Daleks. The return of the normal Daleks from Skaro, and Davros makes himself like a great healer on the planet Necros, making humans eat their dead relatives. Not very good, but it's a very good and dark Dalek story. Absolutely amazing. So that is all I own for season 22. Now that is the entire whole season 22. Six stories, seven DVDs, because I got the original release of Adventures of Varos. So, time to move on to season 23. Season 23, and as you can tell, the figures have changed into Colin Baker with his costume from season 23, Story Terror of the Vervoids. So, what can I say for this? Well, season 23 is an extra whole DVD box that contains four DVDs. And here it is, the Doctor Who, other known as The Trial of a Time Lord. Now, this one is a whole season in one box set, and this was broadcast from the 6th of September to the 6th of December 1986. I absolutely love the season. I absolutely love this. This was the very first ever Colin Baker season I saw. The very first story of Colin Baker was Time Lash. This was the very first time I actually sat down and watched an entire whole season of his. So for this, you have parts 1 to 4, which is the mysterious planet, where the Doctor goes to the planet Ravalox, the planet Ravalox, which is also known by Earth because the Time Lords destroyed us by a great giant sun ball. It's described as a big giant ball of fire. I absolutely love the story. The villain is the robot. We have the very first appearance of Zavalon Glitz, who becomes a kind of character for the next two seasons, this season and season 24, which I will get there straight after I finish this video. So we have the mysterious planet. We have Mind Warp, which is Nicola Bryant's last ever story as Perry. And we have the return of Sylph from the season before in season 22. It's actually quite an enjoyable story. I love this one. So we have a very good mystery murder story, and it is Terror of the Vervoids, or people call this the one with the giant vagina heads. I actually kind of don't really see that relevant. I actually quite enjoyed the story. It's really enjoyable, especially when you watch it on the new version, on the Blu-ray version, which I'll show you in a bit. Sorry about that. I absolutely love Trial of the Time Lords remix. This is a remix version I'm listening to while I'm using for background noise. So, then we have the last ever DVD for this season, which is The Ultimate Foe. Now, this is the return of the Master, and this was the last ever story. Well, part 13 was the last ever Doctor Who episode to be written by the fantastic Robert Holmes, who's been writing Doctor Who since the 1960s. Because, unfortunately, he passed away right in the second part to the story. And Pip and Jane Baker had to quickly jump in to finish it off. Now, this is an absolutely fantastic story. I quite enjoyed this story as well, especially when it ends really, really well. It's with the Doctor's last words, carrot juice, carrot juice, and carrot juice. So, for DVD-wise, this is the whole of season 23. Now, often known as Trial of a Time Lord. Sorry, Mr. Colin. We need to move forwards a bit. There we are. Is that all I own for season 28? No, because I actually do own the season in Blu-ray as well. DVD and, of course, Blu-ray. I absolutely love season 26. It's an amazing season. I can't... Especially with the Blu-ray. I love the new version for Terror of the Vervoids with all the court trials caught out. Because the Doctor is on court in this story. Especially where you have the Valyard. And then the only thing I don't really like about this is where... Every time we come to a court scene, like nearly the end of the episode, where it goes, where the Valyard says, I demand the doctor of his life. And it literally just cuts to Colin Baker going, facial expressions. And then it just plays the title sequence. I really don't like that, but I do like the rest of the storyline. It is an amazing storyline. I absolutely love Trial of a Time Lord. It is not as bad people... It's not as bad people say, but yeah, I own Trial of a Time Lord on, of course, DVD and, of course, Blu-ray. So that is the Colin Baker year with one story from season 21 and the two main seasons of his. Join me in the next video where I talk about the DVDs and the Blu-ray releases we get for Sylvester McCoy, the Seventh Doctor. Thank you for watching. Please do like, subscribe, and please, please do share my videos, because it will mean so much to me to have my videos shared. Really, really, it would really, really mean so much to me. Thank you for watching.